with me. They don't know, they don't really know. And I hope that they really know. They don't know, they don't really know. And I hope that they really know. Every time I close my eyes, your beauty reaches for me deep inside. From the most of the trees inside, your beauty is a paradise.
The world's eyes in many ways are on the culture of West Africa at the moment. Because the culture of this part of the world is so thriving and rich and colourful, the music, the art, the creativity, in many ways this is it's booming in Nigeria these days.
In 2022, the Benin bronzes are returned from Germany to Nigeria. Within this framework, the German Archaeological Institute launched the Edocation Project with funding of the Federal Foreign Office. The focus is on research and joint learning. The DAI supports Nigerian archaeologists on site with further training and modern equipment, such as drones. Together, Nigerian and German researchers investigate the archaeology of the Kingdom of Benin.
Edocation is a project running from 2022 until the end of 2024 at the DAI.
This was different from many of the other German Archaeological Institute's projects in that it wasn't just a research project. We're working together to create a permanent center for archaeology in the region. So training people and leaving behind the skills which you bring to the project is absolutely fundamental. It's not an optional extra. It lies at the center of what we're trying to do.
We have spent the last 2 years thinking very critically about the gaps that exist in terms of capacity, in terms of facilities, in terms of opportunities for young practitioners and artists in Nigeria. And that's really at the heart of what our collaboration has been with the German Archaeological Institute.
One of the first activities of Edocation when we were here for the first time was the documentation of Ogamen House, or the Ogamen Residency. The Ogamen Residency is one of the oldest buildings in Benin City that is still standing and in its more or less original condition. Most of the times the method that we use in Project Edocation is structure for motion photogrammetry. In that method you have to take a lot of pictures from an object, from a landscape, or from a building like the Ogamen House we are standing in. From these pictures and with the help of special software you can create a 3D model. The 3D model is very useful for creating plans of the architecture, of documenting the preservation of the building, and to show Ogamen House to the public.
I couldn't understand why Benin archaeology escaped the attention of the archaeologists all over the world since the 60s. But now we have the attention of DIA and we have attention of MOA, these two organizations collaborating to work on the moat.
It quickly became clear that addressing the questions surrounding the Benin moats was a very high priority.
You can describe them as earth walls or earth works. You have a wall, a rampart, and then a ditch next to it.
Some said that they were for defense, and other people said no, they were not for defense, but for administrative purposes.
The Moats of Benin are among the biggest archaeological monuments worldwide, so they are very significant on a global scale.
There hasn't really been a lot of more recent mapping of these ancient monuments.
The moats, we are documenting them, we are flying with drones above them, and we are measuring them with GPS.
We need to make sure that with time, all over Nigeria, people are well equipped to use the drone, being able to map places.
My geological background gave me a theoretical insight into all these things, but not practical insight until I got exposed and I exposed to those equipment. That was when I started practicing.
Our aim is to map all the moats here in Benin. So to start the drone, we look for places where we don't disturb people, for example, high buildings. High buildings also have the advantage that we have a better connection to the drone.
One of the main outcomes is a map of the inner city moat that shows the condition of the moat, but that also shows the current extent of the moats. And this way we can also compare their current preservation to the preservation in the 60s, and we can figure out how in danger they are.
So we are trying to see the relationship that people who live around the moat, the relationship they have in interacting with the moat over the years. And one of the things that we notice is that the moat is not in its best condition, because we can see human activities and people are really, really not paying attention to what their heritage looks like and the story that is behind this moat.
Anytime we are talking about the moat, we should as well talk about the people that built the moat. We are able to engage with the people, and it enables us to give a human face to our mapping. One of the important places we went to is called Uhun Idumu. We found out that the community is a very, very old community, and it is home to a very important shrine in Benin, the Olokun Shrine.
There are different Olokun in Edo State, but this is the number one, because the Oba live in this community at the ancient time.
We had a lengthy discussion asking several questions about the oldest building in that community, the oldest family. We also talked about the boundaries, the extent of the boundary of the community. We are taken to the moats, near the moats where they extracted rock. From what we are told, this has been a long time tradition in the community. The community is known for chalk production. So the community mapping kind of complements the mapping done using LiDAR and drones. You get a better context and a better understanding of the moats.
End of Project Education next year, 2024. Our Nigerian colleagues will stay, they will continue their work here in Benin City, they will continue their research here in Benin City. Oh,
project. For me, it feels like I'm helping to promote the culture and heritage of my people.
Getting to work with AI was an opportunity to get developing digital skills that is applicable to archaeological studies or archaeological projects.
I've been able to learn a lot. Yeah, you know, sometimes you just feel like, man, I never knew this lot. But now working with these guys, it's like a whole new world.
So this has really been the coming together of resources and knowledge from other parts of the world within Nigeria to really make, hopefully, something that's really special and profound.
So it's time to sit on the earth and all talk. And after we're done, we take a moat walk. I say it's time to sit on the earth and all talk. In hand, let's take a moat walk. Yes, let's unify y'all. Akubwe.